Being a student is now more difficult than ever. Once graduated, students face up to paying up to £50,000 in debts back. But is £9,250 really worth it? You only repay 9% of everything earned above £25,000. Earn less and you don't repay. But is this a sustainable form of education funding? By talking to students themselves, I want to find out what they really think.
I have no idea where the £9,000 goes. No idea.
I'm not too sure where the £9,000 goes. I think to the university, but I'm guessing. I don't really know.
Not really. I think it might go to equipment, but I don't really know.
I would imagine it goes towards paying tutors and for equipment and for the maintenance of the university, but obviously we never physically see where it goes, so I don't think any student really properly knows.
I'm guessing it goes towards the university and all their equipment.
My £9,000, I think it goes towards the uni to help funding, I assume.
I think it's justified in the sense that we have a lot of equipment, but at the same time, the equipment isn't up to date in a lot of cases, and we don't have a lot of teaching hours. You know, we're only in a couple of days a week.
On this course, I've had sort of access to jobs and good opportunities, but at the same time, I have had to teach myself a lot of stuff.
Well, I'm into my second year, and I would say no, that it isn't justified. That £9,000, not at all justified.
No, I think it's a bit too expensive for what it is, you know, for what we get here. It's not really worth it.
Unless I'm actually making enough money to pay it back, I guess I don't have to worry about it. And I'm hoping that by the time I'm making enough money, it won't really matter to me. But at the moment, I'm not really that bothered, to be fair.
A little bit. Sometimes I get worried about paying the debt back.
I don't worry about paying my debt back yet, because that's quite far in the future. So I'm trying not to think about it. But I think with this sort of industry, it could go either way. You could either have enough money and not have to worry about it, or you could not have enough money, you don't have can't find any work, so you won't reach the £20,000, so you won't have to pay it back.
Obviously, at the end of the day, it's a lot of money that from your wages that you'll never actually see because it goes straight away, but I don't imagine I'll ever pay it back, especially if I do an extra year to train to teach. So I'll pay back as much of it as I can, but I don't imagine I'll pay back at all, so I'm not too worried.
I'm meeting with Calvin Rogerson, the Labour candidate for Dalston, to hear his opinions as both a politician and as a student.
I think lowering tuition fees but also introducing more apprenticeships would encourage more young people to get into higher education anyway. I know for myself, as a social work student, they're introducing the social work apprenticeship, which means that students don't have to worry about, you know, they're getting that degree, but they don't have to worry about that debt or that burden of debt. I think every student that has to pay tuition fees worries about having to pay their tuition fees back. It's a very real worry, you know, and especially when there is an interest rate that is just, it's like, how can anyone pay it back on top of those interest rates? It's impossible. And the old line of, yeah, well, after 30 years, you don't have to pay it back. Well, yeah, that's fair enough. But up until that 30 years, I'm still having a chunk of my wage going that I've worked hard to get to. You know, I'm from the working class, and I've worked hard to get to that point where I can train to be a social worker. And I don't want to have to worry about my hard-earned money going towards paying off something that I believe should be free. But not only that, you've got other students who are wanting to get into other highly paid jobs that can't do it because they're from a low socioeconomic background and they don't have that ability to get into the middle classes.
As both a student and a politician, Calvin agrees that the tuition fees are a financial burden as well as a key reason to why university numbers are dropping. Mike Plum is a finance student who sees the issues in a different light. I'm meeting with him to hear his opinions.
£9,000 sounds like a lot of money until you start to think about it. So wages are always the biggest part. So university professors are understandably very rare, so you got to pay them a lot of money, otherwise I'll move on. But then you start thinking about it, and 9,000 is not actually a lot when it comes to wages and generally equipment, purchasing and other expenses. Do I think lowering the tuition fees would attract more people to university? Yes. But you've got to think about, are those people going to be able to pay it back? Because there's no point in lowering the tuition fees down to 3,000, for example, like it is in Scotland, and then a quarter of your graduates never getting a job. You know, when you take on that 9,000, a lot of people don't realise that is your first step, real step anyway, into adulthood. You know, you telling the university, yes, I can pay that back, and I will pay that back. And that's your job. For 40 years, that is your job to pay it back. I think a lot of people in the UK think that universities are a right, not more like a privilege, I guess. If you're going to university, you should have the initiative to become successful.
From all the people I've spoken to, there is a lot of differing opinions about whether the £9,000 is worth it. We tried contacting people in the university to find out where the money goes. However, they all refused to comment. The lack of transparency with where the money goes means students don't understand whether their money is worth it. So what do you think?